The primary goal of air circulation within a ventilated indoor garden is to homogenize the supply of fresh air in the grow room or grow tent, the idea being that all of your plants will benefit equally. Remember, plants feed on atmospheric carbon dioxide or CO2 in order to grow, bud, flower, and fruit. Normally, CO2 hovers around just 400 parts per million in the atmosphere, but inadequate air movement in a grow room full of hungry plants will quickly lead to pockets of CO2 depleted air around your plants' leaves. Eek! You're also more likely to suffer from molds and mildew issues due to localized high humidity, not to mention those hot spots that can develop directly below your grow lights, and last but not least, you'll definitely be making life easier for humidity-loving pests such as scary ad flies, aka fungus gnats. So, what can you do? Well, you've got to move that air, amigos. Indoor growers and greenhouse growers use oscillating fans to simulate an ice-gentle, ubiquitous breeze. You can buy small ones that clip onto a grow tent pole, medium-sized ones that stand or sit on a stool, or big, chunky ones that sit on either side of the floor on an adjustable vertical mount. Most growers in tents or small grow rooms aim to position their oscillating fans to move the air in between the plant canopy and their grow lights. Also, when your plants are older, it's a good idea to strip away leaves and stems around the lower third of your plant so that you can get some air flowing beneath the canopy too. Watch out for stagnant corners. It's no accident, my friend, that mold tends to accumulate where walls meet. A little leaf litter is a good thing. That shows that air is being moved around gently. Some plant species, such as basil, are particularly sensitive to wind. You only have to look at their delicate little leaves to see that, but other woodier species, such as rosemary, are a lot hardier. Also, be particularly careful with young plants. Sure, a little air movement can help developing stems to strengthen, but too much will have a drying, moisture-sucking effect on young plants. And watch out for taco-shaped leaves, a sure sign of localized low humidity stress. Now, on the other side of the scale, too little air movement can cause a condition called edema, sort of water blisters on plants' leaves that show they are retaining abnormal amounts of water. Chilies are particularly susceptible. Now, remember, an oscillating fan won't lower temperatures in your grow room. That's the job of your extraction and input fan, or your air conditioner, depending on the style of grow. I like to use a little ducting to channel my input air to my plants. Otherwise, around waist height is optimal for your input. Position your extraction point at the opposite end of your grow room so fresh air has the most chance to circulate. In larger operations, growers use large air blowers like this blower from Hurricane. I find these to work great when pointing upwards off the floor, helping to displace the cooler air that tends to settle on the ground. When choosing an oscillating fan, go for the biggest that's practical, but make sure it has 2 or 3 speed settings and at least a 4-foot long cord. A good place for an oscillating fan is right in front of your air input. Obviously, the advantage of wall-mounted fans is that they don't take up floor space, but they're less portable. However, they're ideal for solving those stagnant corner issues. Your plants will benefit more and more from air movement as they mature. Budding and flowering plants tend to enjoy lower humidity, and this is also a danger time for molds. So crank your oscillating fans up to full power during flowering. Air movement is essential 24/7 in your indoor garden. So don't, whatever you do, have them switch off when your lights go out, as your fans will help to diffuse all that extra humidity should temperatures fall at night in your garden. Plants breathe or respire at night too, so air movement is a must. 2 16-inch fans are more than adequate for my 200-square-foot garden. If you're unsure if you have enough, take a stick, attach a feather or some paper from your shredder to the end, and hold it aloft in various locations in your garden. If you don't see a flutter, you need more airflow, my friends. I particularly like these Hurricane freestanding fans because they're portable and they sport all the speed and movement options that any grower could desire. Like, it can move side to side or in a W shape, like a politician nodding at a crowd. It can be raised up around 30 inches, which is high enough to peek over the canopy of most plants. Otherwise, a wall-mounted model is your best option. One drawback is that they don't switch back on after a power outage, but there are other models with manual on and off buttons that do this. As your oscillating fans will be on 24/7, do take a moment to forecast your power usage. Around 50 to 90 watts on high is normal for a 16-inch fan, and anything up to 200 watts or more for larger beasts. My best advice? Just go on and add another oscillating fan to your grow. Your plants will thank you, and if not, hey, at least you'll have a spare. Hey, finally, don't go cheap. Buy a brand that's been designed for the grow room, not the office. Okay, feel free to hit me up with your fan questions, but nothing too personal. Seriously, I love discussing the content of these videos with you almost as much as I do making them, so don't be shy about hitting that subscribe button and sending your queries and feedback my way. Until next time, amigos, this is Everest blowing like an overly friendly wild daffodil in the wind. Later.